Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Dragon's Library. So today, well, we have something out of left field. See, I was originally going to review the new season of Disenchanted, Disenchanted Season 5, which I will get around to reviewing eventually from Netflix. However, I was recommended a show called Captain Laserhawk, a Blood Dragon remix by a friend, and I watched the first episode, and the next thing I knew, 2.5 hours had passed and I'd watched the entire series. So I clearly want to talk about this, and I'm going to be talking about that instead. As a result, this video might be a bit delayed and probably won't be coming out until Monday. That's when I'm hoping it'll come out anyway. So, let's move on to what the hell this is. Now, first up, I'd like to say, if you've only seen this as like one of the tall posters on Netflix's, you know, new originals thing, you might have only seen like some guy with a generic, you know, cyberpunk arm standing in front of a generic background. This show is actually way better than that. It has one of the shittier YouTube tall thumbnails. So please watch this show. To try and describe what it is a little weird. Basically, it's set in 1992 in alternate history where the United States has become a dystopian, cyberpunk, technocrat future ruled by a megacorporation called Eden. They've also created animal-human hybrid creatures and Dolph Laserhawk, which is just such an over-the-top name, I love it, was a super soldier. He was modified with, you know, cybernetics and upgrades, you know, made to be a super soldier and all that blah. Very much a generic backstory. He went rogue, and, you know, befriended a member of the Resistance. However, during a final heist, he suffers a great betrayal and is imprisoned in a Supermax black site. However, this is where the Suicide Squad show happens, because the warden of the prison needs them to all join up to deal with some evil task that's against Eden's interests. So she gathers up 4 prisoners, well technically 5, but you know, you got someone to get their head blown up, in order to undergo Eden's shadowy agenda without Eden having to officially tie their name to anything. Dolph is like, screw you, no. But then she's like, no, your first mission is taking down Operation Run by that friend who betrayed you. And he's like, okay, I'm on board, let's go. The other members of the team include a pig animal hybrid who's based on a character from Beyond Good and Evil, and his adopted daughter Jade, who's also based on Beyond Good and Evil. Then you also have the frog hybrid assassin called Bullfrog, who is a member of the Assassin Order from Assassin's Creed, and you also have Captain Dolph Laserhawk. Now you might have noticed, hey Davis, that's a lot of Ubisoft games you've mentioned. Yes, Pagan Men from Far Cry 4 is here as well. Also, Eden is clearly being run by the Illuminati from Assassin's Creed, and you have things from, like, every possible thing. You have Sam Fisher from the Splinter Cell series. You have a set of Power Rangers who are kind of, like, themed, sort of like the operator from Rainbow Six Siege. Basically, this whole world is a dystopian Ubisoft crossover, with Rayman literally being the face of Eden, because he used to be Ubisoft's friendly character mascot back when that was a thing companies had. It is insane and wild, and the show goes through so many different art styles, switching between classic 2D animation to slightly more stylized stuff to pixel art. And finally, for one episode, they have like half of it set with full-on FMV style graphics with like pixelated borders around essentially live-action figures, but digitized and processed in a way that looks animated. It's all crazy and insane, and a spectacle of over-the-top fights, action scenes, surprisingly compelling characters, and despite the show being like very irreverent, very funny, very just amazing to look at and get caught up in the fight scenes, it has a deep underlying sense of tragedy to it by the end, where you're like, huh, I think the world's just kind of fucked. All in all, this show is, I can't even describe just how amazing it felt to sit down and watch this thing. I highly recommend anyone who wants to go see something like this, watch this. Heck, I remind even people who don't usually watch this kind of thing to watch this. Even if you're not into Ubisoft as a franchise, you don't need to know anything about their games. I've only really played Assassin's Creed Black Flag and a bit of Far Cry 3, okay? I'm not a huge Assassin's Creed or Far Cry fan, I'm not a huge Ubisoft fan. I think a lot of their modern stuff is very repetitive and dull. But I genuinely think this is an amazing show, and quite frankly tells me that Ubisoft shouldn't be making video games, they should be making TV shows, because someone over there clearly has more passion for this than every single person who's worked on an Assassin's Creed game for the last like 5 Assassin's Creeds. I'm sorry, this is just such a insane difference in quality between their video game work and this that it's not even fun. Moving on to the conclusion, Captain Dolph Laserhawk, a Blood Dragon remix, is just a crazy, over-the-top show with spectacular animation and a collage of beautiful styles, taking characters, themes, and ideas from basically every Ubisoft platform to create one of the most compelling crossover works I've ever seen. It is an amazing show on both the writing, technical, and visual, and just overall enjoyable level that I genuinely don't know why anyone wouldn't enjoy watching this. It's just a balls to one, fun, great time. 10 out of 10, Ubisoft, what the hell are you doing with your video games? Clearly, you need to inject some of this passion over there. So, yeah. I know this review is very short, but like I said earlier, this show is pretty short as well. There are only 6 episodes for 20 minutes, so there wasn't a whole lot to say. In addition to this, we also have our announcements. I am going to be working on my Disenchanted Season 5 review, and I am also going to be streaming on Monday and potentially Tuesday for Bloodborne for a Halloween stream. I'm unsure if I'm going to be doing Bloodborne or Lies of P on Tuesday. We'll see how that plays out. Moving on from there, we have the out card. You know, go down here in the subscribe orb, click on it, subscribe, view YouTube recommends, and also a playlist of all the stuff I've done this year. Click on either of those, go to my channel, subscribe, watch all my videos, it'll help a lot. And I will see you all next time. Bye!